Hello, this is part two of chapter nine. In this segment, I will discuss briefly intelligence. So we started out by giving an overview of the major theories of intelligence. That would be Spearman's general factor theory, the idea there being that there is a general intelligence that underlies abilities in different departments of people's functioning and lives. So for example, if a student is good in math, he or she tends to be also good in English, anatomy, sociology, etc. Later on, Howard Gardner developed theory of eight intelligences. Those would include linguistic, mathematical, kinesthetic, naturalist, etc. And then we discussed in more depth Robert Sternberg's triarchic theory of intelligence, which basically outlines three major types of intelligence. One being analytic, which would be the school smarts. Those would be the people who do really well in school, who go off to medical school, law school, graduate school, who become doctors, lawyers, university professors. The second type was practical intelligence. Those would be people who are really good at solving everyday problems, adapting to new situations. I gave the example of children, the homeless children living on the streets in Brazil, and how they become very successful entrepreneurs. They would have very high practical intelligence. And finally, creative intelligence, which would include the artists, the musicians, sort of the people who are very creative in their professions, but they could also, it could also include, let's say, a CEO who recognizes the need for his company to innovate and comes up with innovative strategies for moving forward. A couple of important things that I'd like you to be familiar with when it comes to Sternberg. One is that he was very actively involved in going to different countries, studying different cultures, and understanding what constitutes culturally intelligent behavior. And then with his team, he devised culturally sensitive tests. So Robert Sternberg has done a lot of good work in recognizing and working to overcome the natural cultural biases that we see in a lot of the standard intelligence tests as we know them in the US and a lot of Western cultures. The second important contribution of Robert Sternberg that I would like you to be familiar with includes his development of college admission assessments. I've mentioned that he came up with assessments of creative and practical intelligence assessments. Those would be administered in conjunction with the SAT, SAT being the test that assesses for analytic intelligence. And the tests that Sternberg developed actually turned out to be solid, very good predictors of first year success in college, and they have reduced the racial and ethnic gap that's so common in the college admission process. This is a very brief video. I want to stop right here, and we will discuss the chapter 10 in our next video.